what the hell is going on, Sam? You came here to invade my birthday.
Happy birthday!
You know what I'm saying? It's just, you know, Sam Roberts came to annihilate me. And then,
but you know what the problem was?
What happened?
When I sing happy birthday, it doesn't sound good. I don't have a good singing voice. I can't sing that song.
So you brought somebody here that's an expert?
That's right.
A vocalist?
That's right. And I brought a vocalist for you.
And the guy who brought the raccoon hats back in the game, because, you know, he's the reason I bought a raccoon. I was in Russia. I bought a raccoon hat out there. Usher, what's up, man?
80s baby. That's what I am. You know what it is. Always rocking out. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, you make that raccoon shit look hot. I don't think anybody can make it hot, man.
Yeah, well, hey, man, you got to believe it in order to make it happen.
Are you getting a percentage of that?
Nah, man. Nah, man. It's just the flavor.
Yeah, white people pissed off out there. We stole the raccoon hat from white people. But anyway, Usher's birthday. Yo, your birthday's the
13th. Wait a minute. We both Libras. You're the 12th. I'm the 14th. So it's a celebration across the board. You kick it off on the 12th. Oh, and I'll pick up on it, you know what I'm saying, on the 14th. But no, I'm not here to sing happy birthday, but I'm here to celebrate.
Yeah, I think it might be a little odd.
Yeah, that might be a little odd.
we got some bitches or something, man. Yeah, be crazy. Man. Speaking of bitches, man, you have the strip club anthem, I Don't Mind, which with my boy, my brother, Juicy J.
Take off, turn up.
You gave every stripper respect now. Now you got people buying unlimited bottles in the strip club with this record, man.
Yeah, it's fun.
Was it pre-planned or is it because you're from Atlanta?
That's just Atlanta. That's Atlanta right there.
Can you explain this Atlanta thing, why they eat like pork chops in the strip club?
That's the term. No, just come on now. You selling it way off.
Chicken,
like, we just go,
that.
Wait a minute. Like, we go to the strip club to just have chicken and that is really good too. And pork chops? Nah, not really pork chops. I haven't had pork chops in the strip club. Now, I had chicken wings. I didn't have fries, burgers. I didn't have fish. I didn't have all that. I mean, back in the day, they had gold clubs. I mean, if you're from Atlanta, it's a culture. It could be gold clubs, Cheetah.
Mm-hmm.
It could be, you know what I'm saying, Jazzy Tees. It could be any of those. You know what I'm saying? It could be, you know, it could go any way you want, depending on what experience you want. Onyx, if you want to turn all the way up. You know what I'm saying?
I was going to bring that up, too.
Yeah. Strokers, all of them.
Did you learn from Jermaine Dupri? Because he's the one that taught me about
that's Atlanta culture. I mean, until you're of age, you kind of look up to the people who are able to go in, and then eventually you can. It's entertainment, man.
Well, it's not fair because you're behind Justin Bieber and everything. He could get in any spot, man. He's like 12.
Yeah, he probably could right now. He probably already in there.
How's the tour? You got the tour starting November 1st?
The tour starts November 1st. We'll be here in New York City, Madison Square Garden, November the 7th.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, man. But, yeah, you know, it is fun, man. I don't mind. You got to, you know, Teron of Rock City, you know what I'm saying? He's ad-libbing on the record, and he wrote the record. It was definitely one of those, this is instant, and he was so adamant, he and Keith Thomas, about me going in on this record. You know, the last time we had a record together, me and Keith, it was it was Love in This Club. And I said at the top of the song, yo, Keith, you was right. So, you know, the reaction that people are having to this record, rather it was leaked, and then now people are kind of, you know, really on it. Hey, you know, if it represents something that is of the culture, don't look at it as something slimy. Look at it as something no different than how hip-hop has completely adopted Atlanta culture. You got New York rappers sounding like they from Atlanta.
I'm glad you're saying that. Because
but it's the real shit, though, bro. You know, so in terms of the culture of, you know, R&B having fun with it as well, that's what it is. And I made it melodic and sing-along enough for you to have a good time with it.
Good kisser real quick, because the Illuminati trying to get you out of here. you know, speaking of Illuminati, you said the devil is alive. Can you explain that?
I said he's alive.
A lie. Oh, the devil is a lie.
Oh, damn, man.
See, you got to pay attention to the lyrics.
Usher, you do control white people.
You should have seen Usher on the Today Show. You want to talk about people working. Usher's the only person on that whole Today Show concert series that started his performance from around the block.
Get the hell
he
out
went
here.
Around the block, through the crowd, up on stage, and he's still singing the whole time. It was incredible. Incredible.
Talent is something that you have. You could tell who's whack before you get out of here. Can you give us one?
Can I tell you who's whack?
Who's whack right now?
I mean, you are for asking me.
I'll give you a list after this. I'll text it to you.
You can give me your list and I'll just check yes or no.
You came here. You just came out of nowhere. You know, I'm not even prepared. I would have bitches for you.
Jumped out of a cake. It's your birthday.
Man, what are we going to do for our birthdays? Can I come to Atlanta and party?
Man, come on to Atlanta,
a real Usher party?
Actually, we'll still be turning up November 7th here in New York City. Come on down to the
Madison
Square
Garden. So I'm going to
come to that show.
All right.
But now, August Alsina is opening the show with DJ Cassidy as well. I got the
it's my boy
the,
too.
Yeah, I just want to get the mood right, and then you know it's unexpected. The name of this tour is the UR Experience.
UR Experience.
Normally, I would have had an album along with it, but I really wanted to take a beat away from that and just bring all of my audiences together. I didn't try a lot of shit within the last some odd years, as well as the 20-year mark just passed for me as an artist. Like my first record,
20 years, you still look the same.
August. 1994
what?
To 2014. So within that process, there's a lot of education that goes on both ways. Old to new, new to old. And I wouldn't call it old or new unless that's really what it was. But in 20 years, a lot has changed. So I'm bringing everybody together for the UR Experience. There'll be some hot moments, some feature moments. It's going to be some unexpected moments. And Whoo Kid, you got to make sure you come in and have a good time with me.
I will, man. And congrats on Good Kisses being number one.
Thank you, man. Thank
you. Big record, man.
Shout out to the little homie, Chris Brown, for that number one right now with New Flame. Yeah.
Hot.
Loving that. You know, y'all look out for that, you know, for the new record, Body Language with Kid Ink, which is out, as well as I Don't Mind. So we kind of like old school New York in it, where you got to have like at least five records in rotation at one time. That's how you do it.
This guy made $1 billion. He's still got music out.
Still working. Still working.
Goddamn people, and there's more to come. That's what's crazy.
Man,
stay tuned.
Yo, I love you, man. Thanks for coming through for my
Always.
Birthday, man.
Ooh.
Fucking best, man. Best birthday ever. Who's next?
G-Unit?
Oh, shit. 1-888-SHAPE-45.